I'm not a good actor.
Each and all created to share and to receive love unconditionally, unreservedly. Committed love is a gift of the divine, a source far beyond this mundane world. It's too powerful and personal to be explained. It is too expansive and wondrous to keep to yourselves. So we are here, family and friends, to add our joyful energy to this day, to demonstrate our love and support, to celebrate their happiness, to dance with delight, and to toast to their beautiful future. The marriage relationship is truly a gift, a means for two people to mutually share love and grace through the ebb and flow of trials and contentment, frailties and forgiveness, expectations and compromise, that day by day add up to a lifetime together.
Matthew. This could be long. I vow to love you deeply, to encourage and support you to be the best version of yourself. To approach the difficult times with kindness and an open heart, but most importantly, together, side by side in partnership. I vow to trust you in all things that matter. Finally, I vow to be a loving and faithful wife to you for all time.
Brittany, today you make me the happiest I've ever been. Today I ask you to be my wife, my equal. You complete me. You had a part of me that I never knew was missing. The part that makes me whole. I will be with you for your laughter and your tears, your dreams and your fears. And I promise that I will love you every day of your life. And I will protect you from anything that may try to harm you.
Matt, I give you this ring.
Brittany, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
Promise to you.
Declared before our loved ones.
And declared before our loved ones. Is it the right size?
That's okay. Just keep oscillating.
Brittany, Matthew, you have pledged yourselves to each other in the covenant of marriage. You have made promises before your loved ones. You have exchanged symbols of your commitment. Therefore, in the authority of the province of Ontario, but bowing to the far greater power than this, it is my privilege and delight.
Just love each other. That's really got to come down to. Be happy, love each other. Treat each other with respect.
Definitely.
I think I'll go fine.
Respect is
as
important as love. Really.
Yes. Congratulations. Love yous. See yous later.
Just be happy and do things together. Well, we wish them all the best.
Yep, be happy.
Happy
long,
life.
Happy life.
And maybe the odd great grandchild.
Yeah.
I think I've given all my advice, but
never go to bed
angry
or after a fight or whatever. Yeah.
Just always support each other.
Yeah.
We love you so much.
So much, yes.
We've been married a long time. Just stick to it. Everything works out. Just be happy together and appreciate every minute.
She's made him into the man he is now than the little boy he was. I've never seen such a perfect couple. We love them. That's all I can say.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got a feeling that tonight's going to be an incredible night. Make a nice round of applause for our flower girl and ring bearer, Brittany and Trenton. Starting off with Michelle and Cole, best friend of our bride and groom. And now bridesmaid and cousin of our bride. Nice round of applause for Janelle and Stephen, brother-in-law. of honor and sister. Nice round of applause for Brianne and brother Stephen. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to ask that everybody kindly stand at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask that you get your napkins and start waving them over your head because, ladies and gentlemen, we need you to make as much noise as humanly possible. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you, make some noise for Brittany and Matthew, Mr. and Mrs. Goode. In case you didn't know.
I can't count the times I almost said what's on my mind, but I didn't. Just the other day, I wrote down all the things I'd say, but I couldn't, I just couldn't.
Have a nice round of applause for Brittany and Matthew. Mr. Trace Adkins, Then They Do.
In the early rush of morning, trying to get the kids to school. One's hanging on my shirt tape, another's locked up in a room. I'm yelling up the stairs, stop worrying about your hair, look fine. Then they're fighting in the backseat, and I'm playing referee. Now someone's got a girl. The moment that we meet, everybody's late. I swear I can't wait till they grow up. Then they do, and that's how it is. It's just whining in the morning. Starting college, she'll be leaving in the fall. And Brianna's latest boyfriend called to ask if we could talk. I got the impression he's about to pop the question any day. I look over at their picture, sitting in their frame. I see them as babies, guess that'll never change. You pray all their lives, someday they will find happiness. And they do, and that's how it is. It's just quiet and fun.
Started bawling her eyes out, and everyone's like, what's going on? And because I knew her so well, I said, she's just tired. She's overtired. So I take her downstairs to her bedroom, and I'm putting her jammies on. And I said, Brittany, what's the matter? And I said, are you tired? No, I had the worst day of my life. So, my wish for you today, Brittany, is to have another worst day of your life.
Years ago, I made a promise to Jennifer that I would treat all three kids like my own. What the hell was I thinking? Three teenager kids living at home? Crazy. Jokes aside, it's all good. I'm so proud of all of them. They've grown to be amazing adults. And they're just gonna keep going and going. I love them all. And have fun, everybody.
We'd also like to welcome Matt to the family. And I would like to toast the bride.
To the bride.
Brittany is somewhat of a perfectionist, which you all might see that now if you already got your thank you cards, handwritten by the way. So, Matt, Brittany never does things like she doesn't want. She really crawled for a little wee bit, quite a while actually, walked late, never really spoke until she's about two. Again, Brittany does stuff well, right? I'm driving along, Brittany's in the back of the car, and it is a non-stop. You just chatter all the time. Chatter. Well, Brittany, I said, you're talking really well. She goes, yep. And I practice all the time. Yes, you do. So, this is what you're getting into, Matt. Perfection. So I'd like to welcome you to the family also, Matt. Thank everybody for coming. And one last thought, keep in your mind, don't take a spitting pill at the same time you're taking the lock.
Eventually buy us chocolate bars, which is like once a year. Pretty much never. My sister would literally sit in the back of the car, wait until I was done mine, and then slowly peel it open, and then she'd eat it like this.
and chew it so slowly. And I would sit there and I'm almost crying inside. And then I try to get her to share with me. She'd be like, oh no. So those are the two stories I said I wouldn't share. Except for the fact that I wanted to point out that I conned this woman for 8 years. And I wanted to share that. This girl, because of all those things, the crumb and the eating it slowly, I convinced her to eat the cake first and save the icing, knowing full well that she would be full. And I got her icing every single time, and well, until my brother came around, and by the time he was 5, he's like, wait a second, there's a problem. But this one I conned for 10 years. I just wanted to say that. My sister is amazing. She's hilarious. She's very, very smart. And she is beautiful. She is my best friend. I've known her pretty much my whole life. I've known her whole life. And I have many more stories, and if you would like to know, you can ask me in person. I'm writing a book. Matt, I'd like to welcome you into my family and to say thank you for treating my sister so well and all of us so well, and welcoming Brittany and I into your family and being Uncle Matt. That's with a P, in case anybody didn't know. And Auntie Betty, and being two people, because she didn't know who Brittany was. I just told her the other day. That was a thing. That happened. So I just wanted to say thank you so much for allowing me to be part of your special day and for being so amazing. And I'm so grateful to be welcoming a brother into my family. So now I have two. And a beautiful sister. Thank you very much, and I would like to cheers the bride and groom. I would love my drink. That's a good idea. So a big cheers for a long and happy life together. Yep, you can drink. Because I also have this little ditty for a story that my mom used to sing us. And it goes like this. I love you forever. I love you for always. I'm saying love a lot, so that means you have to get up and kiss.
Oh,
so, as long as I'm living, my ditty, you'll be. Okay, now kiss her.
A wise man once told me that the best man's speech should last no longer than the groom's evening of his wedding. Welcome to Brittany and Matthew's roast of your wedding celebration. I actually can't believe you two are allowing me to stand up here. The two of you, because I'm going to talk about the two of you, my new sister, which I'm very happy to have. Seriously, thank you for all the guests for coming here. We got somebody from Australia here. Unbelievable. His brother came from Australia. Good for you. Halifax. We got Halifax people here. We got Quebec people here.
Montreal, Canada.
Montreal. Excellent. You're traveling all this way for a free meal. For those that don't know me, I'm Matthew's only an older brother. We became brothers on June 9th, 1983. That day is called, and it's still known as, the Miracle Day.
That's right.
Yeah, you did say that.
Yeah.
So you may wonder why it's called the Miracle Day. Why did my mother pick that as the Miracle Day? Well, before birth, she had her tubes tied to prevent this from happening. And it happened.
Jennifer.
She announced that she was pregnant. And it's God's gift to the Goode family. The Miracle Day. Where's my sister? We call bullshit. Yeah. I'm sorry for any religious people or anybody that's going to religion or any children in the house. I apologize, but I'm going to carry forward with this. I do remember vividly the announcement to my sister and I. And my sister and I, Tammy, looked at each other and said, what the hell are we going to do here? This isn't going to work. And Mom replied, remember, this is a miracle day. This is God's gift to us. Well, let me tell you, we accepted it. We accepted it, but I did pray to God that night. I said, God, please make sure that this brother of mine is not any more handsome than I am. Please make sure that he's got the good large appendage on his face.
Good thing you wanted to listen, God.
So, upon inspection after your delivery, to my surprise, and I'm so happy, he came out with the good large appendage, and he also came out with another large appendage, so that's two for me. So, I have the mic, right? My dad also prayed that night. He said, God, like any other father would do, please make my son well endowed. For the Quebec people, that's large genitals. No, sure. Come on, Sylvain. So my dad was in the delivery room and he was so excited because when he came out, holy cow, his dreams came true. And the doctor said, I'm sorry, Mr. Goode, that is not what you think it is. That's his thumb. When I was, hey, I told you, Mom, this was going to happen. And I have no alcohol in my system whatsoever. Regardless. So, one of my firefighter friends came up to me the one day and he said, you have a brother? And I said, yeah, I have a brother. He says, does he have a large thumb? Yeah, he's got a large thumb. Is his name Matthew Goode? And I said, yeah, his name's Matthew. How the hell do you know this? Well, I was at Niagara Falls, believe it or not, and I see this wax tan with a large thumb on it, and your brother's name was on it. I'm like, oh shit. Yeah, and then all the other firefighters, hey, you gotta bring this guy in, we gotta see this. And Matthew obliged, he came in and showed this thing off. Yes, you did. You should be very proud of that thing. And I'll be talking about it in a couple more minutes. So, you know, there are some guys that walk around with their cute little puppies and they take a baby from a relative or friend to attract the ladies. I took this fella. His thumb attracted so many ladies. Holy cow, look at that. That has nothing to do with what you think it has to do with. They're completely, anyways, that's not what I mean. So, I can totally keep it going. So I do remember visiting my grandparents' farm. We did this on an annual occasion. And anyways, the one day my Uncle Lauren, we were haying, and there was a huge amount of hay on the wagon. And quite often we'd get up on the top and go for a ride. And I said to my uncle, do you think I can drive this thing? Well, sure. Drive it, just go slow and avoid any groundhog holes. So I jumped on it, I revved her up, and I hit a groundhog hole. So the whole family was scattered with the hay. We couldn't find Matthew. Thankfully, his thumb was sticking out, and we found him. You know, my brother played hockey. He wasn't very good, but he wasn't that bad. He started when he was a young teen. My dad, just give me a second, I'm almost done. My dad actually paid him $20 if he got a goal. Now, thankfully, he didn't get any goals. And my dad really needed the money because when he was slapping the boards and cheering the son on, his teeth came out and landed on the ice. So he needed a new pair of teeth. I'm almost done. Listen, so I asked my mom, I did go over and I asked her, I don't remember because Matt's much younger than I am. What do you know about this kid of mine? Like this kid that is a brother of mine. She said, I don't know. I was too busy chasing after your sister because of her misbehaviors and you. But he was very meticulous about what he wore. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me? He's meticulous about what he wears? Look at these socks. He picked the socks out.
Did you pick these out?
And these are the stupid hats he used to wear. And in fact, I think you still wear them. It's the same type. I actually tried to get into your house the other day, but all your doors were locked. So, Brittany, bride. You're caring. Like my dad said, you're considerate, you're smart, you're generous. And your personality lights the room. But there's another Brittany. Brittany and I and my brother and a bunch of other people decided to go camping. And there's a few people back there that were with us. Brittany's a sweetheart. She's not like the Goode family. She doesn't talk about anyone. She doesn't put anyone down. She's a saint. She is an absolute saint. But that particular day, she had a couple drinks in her belt. And I happened to meet her at washers and headbands and all the other games. And I like to brag about it. She didn't like that. The whole new Brittany came out, and I got a whoop right in the back of the head. Something else about Brittany that I love. She's the queen salesperson for our barn. Now listen, before I met Brittany, Polly and I would go out and get a big tube of cream from Walmart for $6.49. It'll last us a year. Brittany comes along with her stuff, and the price is a little bit different. And you get a little tube of something. So Holly told me, go over and pick up her stuff from Brittany. I said, okay, whatever, I'll go over. She gave me the money. It was a lot of money, and I'm handing it to her, and she hands me the very nice looking bag, and I look inside the bag, and I'm like, okay, Holly already knows she likes this stuff. You don't have to give her another sample. Just give us the product that we bought. She says, well, that is the product that you bought. Holy crap. Animals. I'm almost done. I knew Brittany would fit into our family. The first Christmas we celebrated, she gave me a pair of underwear. And a little creepy, very thoughtful, and they're not that comfortable. And your brother. Where's your brother? Is your brother on here? Yeah. Listen, I like your family, but that guy really bothers me. So I don't know where he is. It's too bad I'm about to insult him. So he's at the pool on Thursday night at our rehearsal, and he says, you look just like your brother. I said, what the hell is wrong with you? I'm 6'5", green eye, well built, physical, and this guy looks like he's hungry. He's got shit brown eyes, color coordination to the law. We don't look anything alike. I'll talk to him afterwards. So, to end this, Matt, I'm very proud to be your brother, and I'm very honored to be your best man. Not sure about why Steve's here. But, sorry, Steve. You are one of the most kindest, thoughtful, considerate persons that I know. You and Brittany are a match made in heaven, and you deserve happiness forever. Mom told me that you looked up to me. Well, let me tell you, I look up to you just as much. I'm very proud of you. I'm so happy to have a new sister. I love both of you. And Matt, you are a miracle, despite the things that I've had to say here. Mom told me to say that, by the way. Listen, I want to thank everyone. A toast to the bride and groom. Happiness forever. And health. Come up to the mic. Can you hear me? Come up to the mic and you've got to sing a love song. And it's got to be a love song. It can't be something made up, Interior Spider, whatever. It's got to be a love song.
No more off the originals?
And at least three people? No. As long as it's a love song, then we won't honor that. It's got but to start us off.
So, before everyone got too settled for the evening, we just wanted to thank everyone for coming tonight, and in particular, we wanted to single out a few key players. So, thank you for bringing everything together today.
Shared speech. Our parents, none of this would be possible with them too. Welcome to the faith.
Mom and Dad, Dad, you worked so hard. You actually built stand there for the cake, cupcakes. You worked really hard on that. I'd like to thank you for that. Mom, the countless hours of us sitting at your dinner table and discussing that for a big day. I really appreciate that.
Dad and Linda, you pulled together an ice shower to honor Matt and I since we were iced out at the first Diamond Dough. We appreciate you very much for that. So that was awesome. And thank you to everyone who came out as well. And to Mom and Joe, you gave us your beautiful home and your beautiful property along with countless hours of organizing and finessing. We appreciate you as well. Thank you. To say thank you to our maid of honor, Brianne, and our best man, Steve Goode, for taking such amazing leadership roles today and previously as well, and making sure that we were on time almost to most events and keeping us on track today. Without you, we probably wouldn't have made it here. Brianne in particular, you paved the way for me in life. Thank you for that. The countless musical interludes kept our friendship growing strong through the years. But I think that it all really started, that we really, really, really started to bond when we would go for long car rides, when you just got your license, we'd grab a coffee for her and a tea for me because this was all my coffee. I never did grow up. Or actually, maybe it was when you would sneak me into clubs when I was younger. Maybe that was it. Or maybe it was the recent, mud races or camping together when we didn't quite have enough firewood, but we never let that stop us. Injuries aside. So, you know what I'm talking about. Your love and support has never wavered, and I'm really, really grateful for you, and I love you from the bottom of my heart. A whipple up. Janelle, you've been there and here with full enthusiasm since our very first Starbucks meeting, where I asked you to be a bridesmaid. I have leaned on you, I have relied on you, and I have felt your love every step of the way. We are taboo partners. We are business partners, and we are friends through and through. Thank you. Michelle, we've known each other for so long. You are my longest friend. We've been through a lot together, from soccer teams, to shopping sprees, to being chauffeured around in a red Mustang, and giving each other really embarrassing nicknames, which we will remain secret. Thank you for being here with me today. I love you all. Thank you.
Steven? Good. Best man?
Yeah.
All right, he's got a lot to say. I looked over, he's got a few pages. I'm probably not going to be as mean as him, but that's why I'm better. So, golf yesterday, it was a lot of fun. We went golfing for our bachelor party. Despite a little dispute he had with the situation of the ball, might have played the ball, might not. But whatever, you have to talk to Marshall. It's a long story. It was a great time, anyways, but. He actually ended up going calling the mummy for stories for me. Well, he didn't have any dirt on me, so he figured he'd go to mom and get some. How far he's going to get with that, but. Well, there's a reason that they call me the miracle boy. Let's see, now I lost myself. I trailed off there. Then Steve Brown, my very first and favorite brother-in-law. Oh shoot, Brayden's here now. I added that in last second, that wasn't written down, I'm sorry. But my favorite first brother-in-law. Now Steve's currently in the rank to get kicked out, but it feels like forever since me and Steve have known each other. Although it might not, it might not compare to Jello Shots, or Amazing Races, and Good Stock, or your obnoxious scalding attire that you were wearing yesterday. Maybe talking about your sweet motorcycle that's always one side of the side I'm wearing, and just keep talking about it. Anyways, I'm really glad that you're here standing up with me and sharing stuff with you as well. Cool. At the end there, Cole's he's actually my best friend. He's kindergarten. If you guys are counting, that's about 20 years.
30 years.
Damn, right? Yeah. He's my oldest friend, and he does hold all of my deepest secrets. Well, actually, Steve, you should have went to him if you wanted some dirt on me. So the bartenders over there, if you could just keep them down to a one or two drink limit there, and we'll start talking and sharing all this embarrassing stuff, like, I don't know, burnouts in the blazer that I got first got my license, getting rid of evidence in the quarry, right by my mom's dad's place. I'm just going to start learning stuff now. Maybe racing my mom's Topaz.
Which time?
Oh, which time? Every time we went out. I hold a record that, well, I can't count. Either way, I'm trailing up. I'm not even really going by here. Either way, all the terrible stuff. I am also, like, I can't thank you guys enough for being here and standing up with me up there.
To our flower girl and rain bearer, Brinley Rain Farley, and Trent Goode. There you are. Yes. Thank you. You guys did such an amazing job today looking after each other. We're very proud of you, and I thank you very much. Thank you. To Grace and her lovely assistants, they're still busy at work right now, but we wanted to make sure that we would recognize them for everything that they've done and for the amazing meals. The chicken amazing. Loved it. You both done yourself. Thank you.
For DJ, thank you for our wonderful intros, and thanks ahead of time for keeping us dancing all night long. Hope lots of people are up there and have a good time.
And to Jane, over in that corner somewhere. Without you, there you are. Jane, without you, none of this would have been legal. Thank you. We're very grateful. We're grateful for your wit, for your enthusiasm, and your professionalism today. We really couldn't imagine this day without you. To our lovely bar staff, Gina and wonderful assistant, there she is. Thank you so much for keeping the drinks flowing and our dancing courage high. And to Kelly, who's not here right now because she's over there, she's keeping us all from making sure that we do not drown tonight. So that's very good in the pool area.
Hey, Kelly!
Emily Hacker was right here. You were so easy to work with today. And your wonderful partner, Catherine, who's over there, they're wonderful. we're beyond excited to see the photos that you've come out with today to help us capture our memories. Thank you. Brittany Webster, who's also right here, we're excited to give you your wedding videography start today. And we absolutely love what you've captured so far. That's really, really cool. Your dad is so proud of you, and we are too. Auntie Lori and the Dobsons, thank you guys for throwing a super cute shower for me, or for us, I guess, in May. I love you guys. Thank you very much.
Summer of Goode. And my lovely niece. Can you stand up, someone? She's actually the one that made the cake and all the cupcakes over there. Hopefully everybody's got a chance to get it. She is the CEO of Goode Cakes. And we know she's a little stressed out during this time, and it was a little much, but you did it, and it looks great out of chances over there. Take a look at it, and it's all beautiful over there. We really appreciate all the time.
To Braden and Amy, thank you so much for flying all the way over here.
They came from Australia, everybody.
To be with us tonight, and thank you so much for helping in all the last minute preparations and for being our chauffeur today. We're really grateful for this time together. Thank you.
Uncle Barry and Papa Ed and Lewis, they were our shuttle drivers today. Hopefully people got some rides in their cars. Here the long walk.
And last but not least, to our amazing guests, we're absolutely honored to have you here today to witness our special day and to help us celebrate. We hope to see each and every one of you up at the bar and, of course, on the dance floor. We've written you each a card explaining just how grateful we are. To have each and every one of you here today. Many of you already know I can be a bit of a basket case, emotionally, of course, and just from time to time. So I just wanted to make sure that I had the chance to thank all of you. So that's what the cards are at your table.
You're beautiful, Brittany!
Thank you so much!
I wanted to make sure that if I wasn't strong enough to do it in person, that you all knew how important you are to us and how forever grateful we are that you're here today. So, that's it for now. We hope that you enjoy your meals, and we hope that you drink up at the bar and dance the night away, and please get home safely.
We love you all.
Everything went exactly how I thought it would.
We got the job done.
happier, more beautiful than I would imagine.
Would I be ugly?
Not quite.
I'm kidding.
I'm happier.
Are you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because we're married.
Yeah.
And you're mine for it.
Yeah. Stuck with me now.
Yeah, I'm stuck.
Forever in debt. To our future selves, remember this love. Because it can...
I'm not forgetting it.
It can conquer everything.
Forgetting it. Yeah. And...
when times are tough, remember this.
There's no regrets for today. Everything was perfect.
I love you.
Love you too.